In this, I'm going to explain the React.js programming. I'm going to give you the introduction to the React.js. Then we'll see what are the components or what are the modules available in React.js and how these modules will be used for the development. In order to learn this React.js, first of all, we must know the modal view controller. Just to recall the modal view controller design pattern that we discussed in the beginning of this course. The modal view controller is the basic design pattern that will be used in the web application development. So it is a design pattern. Design pattern is nothing but it is a template solution. Design pattern is a template solution for commonly occurring problem in design. Basically, this MVC is a architectural design pattern. So what is the most commonly occurring problem in design? So we need to connect with the business logic, we need to connect with the database and get the data from the database and present onto to the viewers. So this is the common problem, okay, in which a common flow or common thing, we require a template solution for that. So for this, we need to use the design patterns. So there are several design patterns available in the literature. In this model view controller, there is one pattern that is apt for the web application development, especially three-tier architectures. Three-tier architectures are anything but in the first tier, you will be finding the view. In the middle tier, you will find the business logic. And in the last tier or in the third tier, you will find the databases. So this is what is called three-tier architecture. The model view controller design pattern is used for developing applications in a manner that divides the related program logic into three interconnected elements. What are those three interconnected elements? That is what is called three tiers. That is what the meaning here. A data model, a presentation information, and control information. So this model is responsible for managing the data of the application. It receives the user input from the controller. While coming to the view, it is responsible for all the user interface logic of the application required for presentation of the information. Multiple views of the same information are possible. It is just like you want to view the shopping cart or you want to view the items in the e-commerce website in a list manner or maybe in an images form or maybe in the iconic form. So that is up to you to select in which view you want to go for. So that is multiple views of the same information are possible in case of view. While coming to the controller, responsible for controlling the application logic. This is very important here. It acts as a coordinator between the view and model. It acts as the user input and converts to the command for the model or view. So this is the these are the information. Already we have discussed these concepts in the MVC architecture in the beginning lectures. Just it is a recap. So here, among all these things, a controller will play a major role to connect between the model and the view. So here is the example how the model view controller will work. So shopping list application, just now as I told you, in electronic commerce applications, you will find various items that need to be shopped, that you go for the shopping. And there you will find the shopping item and description in its price, etc. So in this shopping list application, which you are aware of, just to recall, model means here specifies what data the list items should be contained, whether you want to show only the item name, price, or you want to see only the item and price, or what you want to see actually. So that you can select it and you can go for viewing of the selected thing. So multiple views exist for the same item that you want to see. Next one is a view defines how the list is presented to the user and receives data from the model to display. While coming to the controller, add or delete item. Then you can delete the item from the cart. You can also add an item to the cart. So these kind of things will be under the control of the controller. So requires the model to be updated so that the input is sent to the controller, which manipulates the model, and the model then sends updated data to the view. So sort item or name is an example, we can say, in case of controller, controller directly updates the list view without updating the model. Whenever you say sort by popularity, sort by rating, sort by price, price from low to high or high to low, this kind of thing. So here are the here is the architecture how the MVC works. This already we discussed in the previous lecture. Anyhow, it is an example. Why we need to discuss this MVC architecture before starting the React.js is the React.js is a framework that will help us to work with the view of the web application. So is it the only React.js is will support only the view part of the MVC architecture? Yes, obviously it supports only the view part. What to do if you want to implement entire three-tier architecture? That is what thing called full stack development means. The full stack development is totally deals with the three-tier architecture with the MVC architecture. So the three-tier architecture is nothing but here the model implementation, view implementation, and controller implementation. So this full stack development. Full stack development is nothing but the front end, the back end, and that is back end means that is what we call database, and also the business logic. These three things will be included in the full stack development. The combination of multiple technologies used to develop any web application is called stack, which is called here three-tier stack. So what are the platforms that are available for full stack development? Let us examine LAMP. LAMP is nothing but this is Linux operating system, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. There is also another version of the LAMP whenever you use on the Windows operating system, which is called WAMP, WAMP, which is called Windows, Apache, MySQL, and PHP. So this is what is called LAMP. Okay, whenever you use on Linux, it is called LAMP, and whenever you use it on Windows, it is called as WAMP. And next one is MEAN. MEAN is nothing but MongoDB, Express, AngularJS, and Node.js. MERN means MongoDB, Express, React, and Node.js. It means it is a kind of package directly you can install on the computer, so that all these technologies you can make use of and you can develop the applications. So previously this LAMP is very famous, and where you will find an Apache web server and MySQL as the backend database and a PHP for the web development. So these are the four things are packed into one application or one setup environment. Just to by installing the setup environment, you will get all these four installed. Actually, here this Linux is nothing but here the what you call the operating system where you want to install these three technologies. Where in case of MERN, this is also like that: MongoDB, Express, AngularJS, and Node.js. When you install this MEAN, then all these four will come into the picture, or all these four components will be installed on your computer. So this is whenever you deal with both the three-tier architecture, that is both model, view, and controller. Then what is called a full stack development. Here React.js is one which is mainly focusing on the front end application. Okay. Here there is no back end and all. Here we are only focusing on the front end application. So for this, if you install Node.js Node.js, it is sufficient. So with this, you can also run this particular React.js applications. And React.js is very famous for developing the front-end applications for the desktop applications as well as the mobile applications. There are several variants of the React.js that are popular and widely used in the mobile applications, especially mobile application development. That we'll see afterwards. So what is this React? React was created by Jordan, a software engineer at Facebook Corporation. It is a JavaScript library that aims to simplify the development of visual interfaces. So especially visual interfaces are nothing but front end. It is used for building fast and interactive user interfaces for web and mobile applications. It is an open source, component based front-end library responsible for the application view layer. That is, it is responsible only for the application's view layer. That means we are going to focus only on the view part of the MVC architecture. If you want to go for three things, that is modal, view, controller, and data source and all, then we need to go for a full stack development. That is, we need to learn full stack development, then only we can go for developing of the detailed architecture. So we'll see here one by one. Here it is an open source. Open source means this source, you can find it. You can make use of the open, the source code of the React.js framework. And you can also do modifications in that, and you may use it accordingly. Next one is component-based. Component-based means here the, in the React, especially the sections of the view part will be divided into components. If you want to recall these components, components are nothing but which are having its own entities or own properties that will not depend on any other things, which are said to be components. Basically, this component-based application development is a very famous development in software engineering. The reason is it will always support loose coupling and high cohesion. Loose coupling is nothing but one component will not depend on another component. Whenever there is a dependency, then automatically, obviously, if any change in one component occurs, then automatically other components will also be get affected. While coming to this cohesion part means they are independent. These components are independent, which are loosely coupled, but highly cohesive within its structure, so that if any property or behavior that is going to be changed within the components, it will be reflected there itself. And while coming to the front-end library, that means here we are going to make use of the library functions or library components that are especially for controlling the application's view layer. This is what is called React.js is. So this React.js was developed by the Jordan. He is a software engineer at Facebook. In 2013, he developed it. And if you observe the Facebook part, in the Facebook there are several components will be there, and the top layer you will find the user's information, and the right hand side you will find the friend requests and who are the friends who are online, and at the left hand side you will find the events, birthdays and all remaining other things you will find at the left hand side. For example, if any user or if any of your friend was offline, then it will not be shown at the right hand side. If the same friend might have come to the online, that is, he might have logged into the Facebook from his computer, then automatically it will be popped there, or it will be enabled there that this one of your friend was online. So how it is possible without refreshing the entire page? That is the advantage of this React.js, because the Facebook is also a kind of application which was developed using React.js. So there you will find this chat application or the person or the friend who are online as a component. Only the refreshment will happen to that component only. It will not affect the entire page. Just you recall the single page application that we discussed in the previous lecture, in which you are not going to do any refreshment of the entire page. Here, we are going to do only the refreshment to the particular component that is to be refreshed or that is to be updated. That's all. This is the only thing we'll do in the component-based application. So thereby, the entire page refreshment, reloading will not take place. This is what the advantage of the front-end application or application view layer development with the help of React.js. So why React? So the React is required because it is easy creation of dynamic applications. So the dynamic application is nothing but whenever the content was updated or content was changed, dynamically it has to be updated onto the page without complete refreshment or complete reloading of the page. Only a particular component and a particular place has to be updated. So easy creation of dynamic application, a component-based approach is followed in this. Well-defined lifecycle is there, and use of just plain JavaScript makes React very simple to learn and build dynamic web and mobile applications. As just now I told you, the React.js is popularly used for the both dynamic applications of web development, that is at the desktop level, and mobile applications also. Fast render with a virtual document object model. DOM is said to be document object model. It is especially used to process the document of the web page. So usually the web page consisting of opening tags and closing tags, it will be formed in the form of, or it will be structured in the form of a tree, which is called document tree. Here, every tag or every component that we use in this tree is said to be the object. So here, document object model is a tree structure in which the rendering of the document object model is very fast. That is what is called fast render with the virtual document object model. Usually the XML and this kind of technologies will use the document object model in a straightforward way. But here in the React.js, it will use the virtual document object model. Actually, there is a document object model which was in general will be used. But in this virtual DOM, what will happen is the actual DOM, what is there, that will be taken as a snapshot for a periodic time. That means for every time period, a snapshot of the original document object model will be taken. But if any change was occurred, that change will be compared with the snapshot, and the change was compared with the snapshot, and it will observe in which component, which section that update was occurred. Then the virtual DOM, what it will do is, it will only update that part and will take the fresh snapshot of the entire page. So this is what is called virtual document object model will do. Here, instead of applying on the entire DOM, it will take only the snapshot of the previous DOM, or periodically it will consider the snapshot, and it will compare which component is going to be updated, or which part of the component is going to be updated. Only that component will be updated. It's just like whenever your friend came online, automatically at the right hand side of your Facebook, you will find that somebody has some of your friend has came online. So without refreshing of the entire page, this is what the virtual document object model will do. That is what the virtual document object model, which is very fast. So which virtual DOM updates only the items in the real DOM that are changed, or that were changed, instead of updating all components again, as conventional web application do. So whenever you use the conventional web application with XML and all, it will go for refreshing of the entire page. Okay, sometimes you might have seen in the cricket scores update, in some of the pages, if you look at it has to refresh the entire page. Then only the periodic refreshment will be done, all the components will be loaded again, then the cricket score will be updated. So even though it is a periodic update, but still entire page will be reloaded. But in case of this virtual document object model implementation, only the specific part related to a component which is supposed to be updated, that will be updated. Next one is reusable components. Obviously, this is a very, very important concept that need to be required in the web application development, because you cannot build every component from scratch. Sometimes with the simple modifications or little modifications, you may use it again for another purpose in the same page or maybe in another page. So reusable components. Components are the building blocks of any React application. A single app or application usually consisting of multiple components. Just like you recall the Facebook page, on top you will find the user's information. At the left hand side, you will find the events information. Right hand side, you will find the friends request and your friends comments or maybe any other thing. And at the right bottom corner, you will find the friends who are online. So this is what is called components, which are there. And middle, you will find the posts. A single application usually consisting of multiple components that can be reused through the application, which in turn reduces the application development time. Next one is unidirectional data flow. unidirectional data flow is nothing but the data updation or the flow will be from the top in the unidirectional. That means here the React flows a unidirectional data flow wherein data always flow from the parent to the child component, but not to the child to parent. So this is a very, very important thing that you need to remember. Because of this, it is very fast. The application, the updation will be very fast. So here, parent to child component, the data will be flown. And this the unidirectional data flow assists in debugging errors and identification of problematic points in the application. It is just like whenever the updation was occurred, the parent is the root of the page, and the component where the updation has to be done is the child. So directly the component, the updation will be done from the root to the corresponding section of the component. So if any error occurred, immediately you can figure out, okay, this is the problem is facing with this component. So this component code may be rechecked or maybe recoded. Then immediately it will be taken into consideration. So this is what is called a unidirectional data flow. Next one is small learning curve. So even a beginner can also learn this React.js in a very faster way just by putting little effort. So that is the reason it is a small learning curve. React is easy to learn, and as it is mostly combines the basic HTML and JavaScript components with some additional benefits that are already provided with the framework of the React.js. So that is the reason it is a small learning curve we can observe here. Next one is dedicated tools for easy debugging. Facebook has released a Chrome extension that can be used to debug React applications. This makes the process of debugging React application faster and easier. So this is because of these features, we are going to prefer React.js since you are the beginner. Okay, you are the beginner programmer in the for the front-end application. Once you understand the React.js and its architecture and its usage, then it is not a big problem for you to make use of the or learn the full stack development. What are the other technologies that are available in parallel to the React.js? So there exists a technology called AngularJS that will see the difference between what is React.js and AngularJS. The React.js, the initial release was in 2013, and where in case of Angular is in 2016. Latest stable version is 17 version, and in case of Angular that is 11 version. And React is powered by the Facebook and Angular by the Google. And here type is, it's an open source, React is open source, and JS library, that is especially it is used for the front end application. Angular is fully featured MVC framework. It's a, we can say it's a kind of a full stack MVC development. Whereas React is done or coded, or we can, it was written in the JavaScript, where in case of Angular, it is called TypeScript. It's a kind of little small variant of the JavaScript, some coding style and this kind of was different compared to the JavaScript. While coming to the learning curve, that means how fast you can learn React.js, it's moderate here, but in case of Angular, it is a steep curve is there. While coming to the document object model, here the Angular will use regular DOM and React use virtual DOM. It is a unidirectional flow, so it is very fast. Language, JSX, JavaScript and XML, and also simple JavaScript will be used in case of React, where in case of Angular, the HTML and TypeScript are used here. So you need to learn the TypeScript concept here. Data binding, unidirectional, as we have told, as we have just now discussed it, the directional direction of the flow will be only from the parent to the child, where in case of Angular, bidirectional data or data binding will be there. Both the React and Angular are the component based web development, or the development will be done. Self-sufficiency, user interface development only in case of React. Extra libraries must be used if you want any other things. While coming to the Angular, it is a holistic software development all the components like Flutter architecture implementation, full stack can be done with this AngularJS. While coming to the architecture flexibility, in React it is there, but in case of Angular it is not there. Coding speed, here normally you can learn this, and ReactJS, where in case of Angular the coding speed is very slow. The reason is you need to have knowledge of, or you need to have a steep learning curve to learn this AngularJS. Coding speed is, as you know, we have seen, normal and slow. App structure, the application structure that you can develop in ReactJS is very flexible, component based, and only fixed to the view part of the MVC architecture. While coming to the AngularJS, it is fixed. That is, app structure is fixed. You have to use only the components that are there, available there, or the format available there, and also very complex. And it is also a component-based application development, and will support both the modal, view, and controller. Directives, easily understood with the KnowledgeJS in case of React, where in case of incomprehensible without knowledge of AngularJS in case of Angular. App testing, whenever you develop an application, first thing is testing of the application. It requires set of tools to perform the different types of testing, including the unit testing, integrated testing, and many other things. While coming to the Angular, testing of a component, a complete application, is possible with a single tool in case of ReactJS. That is what the merits and demerits are, the merits and limitations of ReactJS and AngularJS. So ReactJS is more suitable whenever you go for front-end application and you want to go for only the unidirectional data flow updations with the component-based view application development. It is always recommended to go for ReactJS.